Thank you, Senator Young. I'm already preparing for my second round of questions, so, and I know you're going to be grilled intensively about the subway action plan and who should pay for it and how we should pay for it. So I want to speak about something a little bit more parochial. As you know, I represent South Brooklyn and Staten Island, two areas that could easily be described as transit deserts in many respects. One of the things we've been hoping for a while in South Brooklyn is the restoration of F Express service. So if anyone on your team could give me an update as to where we are with F Express restoration service.
As you know, we're doing a tremendous amount of work on the F line right now. Mm-hmm. That work is slated to continue through the balance of the year. We will then be taking a look at what opportunities there will be to bring back the F Express service in some form. I think everything's still on the table.
Right, because as you know, in Coney Island, we've seen not just development, but also more people are discovering Coney Island with the rent, and you're smiling, because you know how it's on a summer weekend, we can have up to 1 million people on the beach there and on the boardwalk, and unfortunately, there's only one way in and one way out. It's a peninsula that's only three avenues wide, and when there's any sort of major problem, people can't get off of Coney Island. So we're hoping to get more people on the train and out of their cars. So any efforts there would be great. Two other issues I want to mention. I think one of the great success stories of the MTA in the past couple of years is the changeover at our toll booths to over-the-road tolling. It has really sped traffic across the bridges. However, as we know, not everybody has an easy pass, and there's been some bumps in the road about toll collection. So I just have a question. Since some people are still resistant to the idea of an easy pass because they don't use it enough to justify having to maintain money on it, has there been any thought about allowing people to pay their tolls through another collection? I mean, for instance, is there a way to connect the over-the-road tolling perhaps with someone's cell phone if they have a payment method on it so that they don't get the ticket in the mail, they don't get the violation, they don't get the big fines?
So, Senator, right now, just to show you, we have between 94% and 95% of anybody have any napkins? I spilled my coffee, sorry. Here we go, got it. Between 94% and 95% of all users on all of our tolls have Easy Pass, mm-hmm. and it's expanding even more. We've opened up various different ways in which you can acquire an Easy Pass. You can pay for an Easy Pass with cash in numerous different locations throughout the New York metropolitan area, where, you know, for those people who don't want an Easy Pass because they don't want to be identified through their credit card and all of that, I fully understand that. But you can go to many different delis and bodegas, anywhere where you see a sign where you can buy a telephone card, you can also buy an Easy Pass. So I think we're seeing more and more of that. And I will look into what we do to advertise that so that there's more mm-hmm. of an opportunity for your constituents to see that.
Great. And the final question on this round. As you know, over the past few years, the Senate has taken action to pass legislation to increase the penalties on subway predators, sexual predators in the subway system. Last in June of this year, I released a report that shows that subway sex crimes and arrests have skyrocketed in the subway system. And I know this has been discussed at the MTA board. Unfortunately, these are repeat offenders who find their way into the subway system, and the penalties are almost non-existent. Many of them just get a slap on the wrist, and they're back on the subway the next day. So could you speak at all to the concerns that you have about this level and whether or not you think, I can't ask you to support legislation, perhaps if you do, I would like you to take a look at the bill that the Senate has passed almost unanimously for the past 5 years that would elevate these crimes to the level of a Class D felony and keep these repeat predators out of the subway system.
Senator, we have to do something about this. I mean, there's no question. And if we need legislation to increase the fines, so be it. But the enforcement of it, but we're also, you know, as part of it, I've seen an increase in some of the reporting on this, not just in the subway system, but in parts of the city. And when you look at CompStat reports and various different precincts, we also need to make it easier for those who are, you know, whether it's women or whoever is being attacked in any way, shape, or form, a way in which they can report it, because I think it's very, very important. We also have people on board the trains to deal with these issues. All of our, Ronnie, if you want to talk about the program we have in place.
Sure.
To talk
so
about.
recognizing that this is an unacceptable situation for our customers, we've been working very aggressively, not only with the NYPD and the Transit Bureau and the subway system. We've put our own customer information campaign out about how to report these crimes. Mm-hmm. We've also started this year working closely with the criminal justice offices and trying to pursue prosecution of these recidivists, in order to, as a condition of their parole, including barring them from the transit system. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So we do think there are opportunities for enforcement.
Thank you. And you're right, you guys have put in place some programs to help better identify them and capture them. I'm going to be doing another report soon with the NYPD, and we're going to attempt to display how many of them are repeat offenders, and the vast majority of them are.
Yeah, we have that information. We'd be glad to share it with you.
Thank you.